In America, the 1950s is regarded as a decade of great national growth, civil rights progress, and a significant boom in popular culture. Although there was still war and chaos going on internationally, peace and prosperity held strong from a national perspective. One of the things that really made the 50s one of the most prosperous decades of America's history were the people who helped shape it. One such person was Dwight D. Eisenhower, the 34th President of the United States. Dwight D. Eisenhower was, without a doubt, one of the most influential and important people in America during the 50s. His decisions shaped the nation throughout the decade and further, leaving a legacy of peace and prosperity. One of the first decisions he made to shape the country was ending the Korean War with an armistice. This happened just 6 months after his inauguration as president in 1953 and served as a large step forward for peace during the 50s. Just 2 weeks later, Eisenhower strengthened Social Security, adding coverage to over 10 million more Americans. He also admits 250,000 immigrant refugees into America under the Refugee Relief Act. Adding on to that was his creation of the Department of Health and Education. These actions, being taken in just the first year of his presidency, really helped establish him as a president of action and a president for peace. Martin Luther King Jr. is one of the most renowned and recognizable civil rights activists of all time, and his powerful movement all began right in the middle of the 50s. It started in 1955 with Rosa Parks on a Montgomery City bus in Alabama. When Rosa Parks refused to move after being asked to give up her seat for a white man, she was arrested and fined. The NAACP saw the potential in this event being used for civil rights activism, and the Montgomery Improvement Association was created, with Martin Luther King Jr. as its president. Under King's leadership, the MIA managed to organize a boycott, which lasted for 381 days, and as black workers made up 75% of bus riders, this made a huge impact on the city. On top of that, the NAACP's involvement resulted in a suit against the city, demanding the segregation bus laws be deemed unconstitutional. In June 1956, the Supreme Court ruled in favor of the protesters, ending the segregated buses once and for all. This victory was mainly attributed to King and his leadership, putting him in the spotlight as one of the most prominent civil rights activists in America. Buses weren't the only thing that were segregated during 1950s America. Bathrooms, neighborhoods, jobs, and more were all segregated. One of the most major events that signified a turning point for the way African Americans were treated was the case of Brown versus the Board of Education. In order to understand the case, we need to take a look back on how the situation even occurred. Segregation laws had deep roots in society, and had started back in the 1800s. On June 7, 1892, a mixed-race man named Homer Plessy bought a first-class ticket at the Press Street Depot and boarded a whites-only car of the East Louisiana Railroad in New Orleans. Plessy was apprehended for doing so and was ruled as being guilty, a decision that would have major consequences for black Americans in the future. Decades later, in the 1950s, things finally began to change for black America. Oliver Brown was a man living in the 1950s, who wanted the same things all parents want for their children. He wanted his daughter to attend school and have an opportunity to succeed. Brown filed a class action lawsuit against the Board of Education of Topeka, Kansas in 1951, after his daughter, Linda Brown, was denied entrance to Topeka's all-white elementary schools. The case Brown versus the Board of Education of Topeka managed to get the entire country to reevaluate the way they treated and viewed African Americans. The case effectively overturned the 1890s laws of Plessy v. Ferguson and was a major step in permanently ending segregation in the United States. Racial equality wasn't the only way America changed during the 50s. American society as a whole seemed to be changing for the better. After the tragic times of the Great Depression and then World War II, the 50s signified growth and change. One of the clearest examples of how society was growing is the baby boom. In 1953 alone, more than 3.5 million babies were born in the United States. That generation is now known as the baby boomers. The baby boom signified the true end of World War II, and reflected the prosperity the country was going through at the time. The culture of the 50s as a whole was rich and full of life. The rise of celebrities in music, fashion, and acting also signified positive change. One of the most notable celebrities of the 50s was Elvis Presley. Elvis was a big influence on teenagers and young adults in the 50s. He helped popularize rock music and with it, new styles of dancing and expressing yourself. Many parents worried about their children listening to Elvis Presley because they felt he was improper and would influence them to abandon all order. Elvis is internationally known as one of the biggest stars in history. However, many controversies have arisen about Elvis in recent times. Although he was undoubtedly talented, many of his songs were stolen from lesser-known, underrepresented black artists. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, girl. You're crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Been snooping around the door. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Despite his controversies, Elvis is still regarded as one of the most influential celebrities of all time. Music wasn't the only industry that exploded in the 50s. The fashion and acting industry began to grow in popularity throughout the 50s. One of the biggest stars in cinema and beauty throughout the decade was Audrey Hepburn. Audrey Hepburn was a beautiful British woman who was known for her talents of acting, dancing, modeling, and being a humanitarian. Audrey was originally planning on becoming a ballet dancer, but later found her passion to be in acting and beauty. Her career really began to take off when she was cast in what was arguably her most famous role, Holly Golightly, in Breakfast at Tiffany's.
I love you. You belong to me.
No. People don't belong to people.
Of course they do.
I'm not going to let anyone put me in a cage.
I don't want to put you in a cage. I want to love you.
It's the same thing.
No, it's not. Holly?
I'm not Holly. I'm not Lula May either. I don't know who I am. I'm like Cat here. We're a couple of no-name slobs. We belong to nobody, and nobody belongs to us. We don't even belong to each other. Stop the cab.
Audrey was a true American celebrity. Her talent, kindness, and beauty captivated the country for decades. Although for America, the 50s was full of life, culture, and progress, that wasn't the case for the rest of the world. Internationally, the 50s was a decade full of wars. One war that occurred in the 50s, which many are saying to have ended just recently, is the Korean War. Commonly known as lasting for 3 years, the Korean War began on June 25, 1950, and ended on July 27, 1953 with an armistice. However, a peace treaty is yet to be made, so technically the Korean War is still ongoing. The war started when about 75,000 North Korean soldiers crossed over the border, named the 38th parallel, separating North Korea from South Korea. The Korean War was caused not only by the North Korean communist dictator Kim Il-sung, believing he should govern both Koreas, but also because of the fear of communism spreading and taking over. As a result of this, the war began with North Korea backed by China and the Soviet Union, as well as South Korea backed by 21 different countries, but primarily the United States of America, lending about 90% of the military personnel. On July 27, 1953, North and South Korea signed an armistice. In other words, they agreed to cease fire for an indefinite amount of time, and a new border was drawn between both countries. By the time the war came to a ceasefire, almost 5 million people were dead as a result. Another war of the many that riddled the 1950s was the Vietnam War. The Vietnam War spanned between November 1, 1955 and April 30, 1975. The war began because the communist government of North Vietnam wanted to unite the North and South Vietnam under communism. The government of North Vietnam was supported by other communist countries, the Chinese, while South Vietnam Army was supported by America, who wanted to stop communism from spreading at all costs. After 18 years into the 20-year-long war in 1973, America withdrew their troops from South Vietnam Army, letting North Vietnam completely overtake South Vietnam in 1975, which reunited the two countries into what we know today as the Communist Country of Vietnam.